My name is Juan, and I'll be your captain and storyteller today. For your safety, please remain seated with your hands, arms, legs, feet, and ears inside the boat at all times. And children, please supervise your parents. And parents, please supervise your children. If you do not have any children tonight, please supervise your inner child. Today we'll be visiting the homes of some of your favorite Disney characters. But before we begin our adventure, looks like we're off to... Alright, but we're okay. This is the same whale that told Pinocchio and Geppetto. And Pinocchio was a very smart puppet, and he lit a fire inside his mouth, causing him to sneeze and sneeze so hard. He blew his tail right off, giving us our very own special entrance into Storybook Land. Some people say Monstro just isn't half the whale he used to be. Coming up on our left is the cave of the Big Bad Wolf. And right across from him live his favorite dinner, neighbors, the three little pigs. One living in a house made of straw, one living in a house made of sticks, and one living in a house made of 100% wolf-proof bricks. Luckily for those three little pigs, the Big Bad Wolf does not know how to swim. Coming up on our left-hand side is the quaint little English village where Alice grew up. We sometimes find her daydreaming away, and if we look real close, we'll see the rabbit hole. She followed a very late, late rabbit all the way down, down, down to Wonderland. On our right is the very famous London Park. This is the park where Peter Pan and Tinkerbell showed Michael, John, and Wendy how to fly on their way to Neverland, where they never ever have to grow up. And straight ahead is the city of Agrabah and the Sultan Palace. Right below it in the busy marketplace is where Aladdin first stole Jasmine's heart. These rose-covered archways we're about to pass through are the same ones that Aladdin took Jasmine on a very magical and romantic carpet ride on their way to a whole new world. Please remain seated with your hands inside the boat at all times, for all the treasure in here is enchanted, including the very magical genie left on our left-hand side, which grants you three wishes. Luckily, your first wish has already been granted today, as I am your captain. Coming up on our right-hand side is the cottage for Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs live with their pet duck. And right above that is the jewel mine, where if you look closely enough, only grow 1 inch every year, thanks to a very magical process known only to Tinkerbell and some of our Disney gardeners. In case you're wondering, all of the flowers and trees inside Storybook Land are all 100% real. Some of our trees are old as residents, living up to be 150 years old. Coming up on our left-hand side, under the tree, is the very modest house of Mr. Maw, and the not-so-modest house of Mr. Toadall. But they are probably not old, as they are probably running around Fantasyland on wild adventures, to nowhere in particular. And on our left, once more, are the three Dutch mills. The mill in the middle is famous for housing all the animals during the Great Winter Storm. The other two are just general mills from the Silly Symphony, the old mill. And straight ahead in the Alpine Village is Geppetto's wood shop, where he wished upon a star, making Pinocchio a real boy. On the right-hand side is Captain Eric's ship. It is docked on the same bay where the little mermaid Ariel first rescued him. They now live happily ever after in this beautiful seaside palace. But before the little mermaid moved to the seaside, she lived on our left-hand side under the sea in King Triton's castle with her two best friends, the Bassman and Flounder. like all good stories do. Our story has come to an end today, and I'd like to thank you all very much for riding aboard with me. As we approach the dock, please keep those hands, arms, and fingers inside at all times. And please remain seated unless you'd like to find Nemo the hard way. Once again, thank you very much for riding aboard with me, and I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your stay here at the happiest place on Earth.
Japan's ride was 30 minutes, and then I went on Pinocchio, and then I've just been on Storybook Land, as you've seen, and now I'm in Toontown. I'm going to try and get on Roger Rabbit's ride. I've still got a bit of time until I need to go back to California Adventure and go and see World of Colour tonight, which I'm very, very excited about. So we'll see what the wait time is like for this. It doesn't look too bad, but then looks can be misleading. So we shall see. Oh, it looks like it might be shut actually. That's not good. Hi, is it not working? Is it not working?
It's closed temporarily. Had a little traffic jam with all the taxi cabs. We're trying to sort things out.
Yeah. All right, okay. I'll come back later. Bummer. Damn it. I really wanted to meet, do the Roger Rabbit ride as well. Never mind. Now I'll have a wander, I think. There's a lot of photo opportunities here, which is really nice, except I can't do them because I'm on my own and it looks a bit daft trying to take a selfie and such things, but at least all the little kids are enjoying it. I think it's more for them, this land, than anything. I'm trying to hide out the sun as much as possible because my right shoulder is really badly sunburnt, like crazy. But I'm going to duck into a few shops, I think, and have a look around. I'm looking for pins because I want some new pins for my lanyard that are California specific, so that when I go to Paris in November I can trade them for others if I don't like them very much. Hey guys, just wanted to tell you I've just been to a shop and bought myself some pins, which I'll show you when I get home. But the guy I was buying the pins from was so funny. He asked me where I was from, and then once I finished buying my pins, he was like, "Don't worry, I won't make you go up the apples and pears." And I was like, "What?" And he went, "Apples and pears, that's stairs, right, in England?" And I was like, he goes, "Am I right?" And I was like, "Yeah, you're right, but you're mental." So I was just laughing my head off at that. I found that so funny. Cast members are so great here. Like, they properly interact with you and they make you feel all loved and they want to be your friend. Whereas in Paris, you have to interact with them. Whereas over here, they just will come up to you and start talking to you if they think you're alone or you need some help or anything. It's fantastic here, the atmosphere. And it's down to cast members, I think, that help with this great atmosphere here at Disneyland. I'm now going to head over to California Adventure and mooch around a little bit because it's getting on towards World of Colour time. And what is it, 6:45? And then I might go back to Disneyland and do a couple of rides on Splash Mountain in the dark because I am loading up my photo pass with plenty of photos to take home. $108 worth. Yeah, I can't get over it. Like, there's prices on things and you think, oh, that's a really great price, and then they add tax of like a dollar to a couple of dollars, and I'm just like, why not just cost it that anyway? And I don't know. So yeah, I'm just slowly making my way over to California Adventure. I am getting to the point where I can barely feel my feet and I'm hobbling. It hurts to walk. I am getting tired. But I need to find where the blue area is for my fast pass now, actually, for World of Colour. And then, I don't know, I could do Tower of Terror again, I suppose. Or maybe I could do Grizzly River Rapids if it's still going, because I haven't done that yet. Decisions, decisions, it's a hard life being me.
Games that test your skill. You'll find it's all that and more right here at Big Bang Media. You'll love this game, it's so insane. Everybody, I said everybody, play it. Everybody say it, it will be the same once you play this game.
Meatballs and spaghetti pomodoro from Boardwalk Pasta, Pizza and Pasta. Very, very filling, very, very nice, but too much food. I've eaten too much, but with the sundae and the spaghetti at lunchtime, and now this. Oh my god. Over there, through the trees, I don't know if you can see, that's Paradise Pier Hotel. When I next come back to Disneyland California, and I will, I'm going to book into that, and I'm going to make sure I've got a room on the outside there, because from there, those windows, you've got an excellent view of World of Colour. And imagine just being able to look out your hotel room window and see World of Colour without having to get a fast pass. I've asked information about where my blue area will be. Apparently it's to do with light bulbs. I've got to look for blue light bulbs to find the blue location area for World of Colour. Hopefully it will be in a good spot. I'm just hanging out now because my feet are killing me. Like, I want to rip my shoes off and just like chill for a bit, so I might just sit here. It's 7 o'clock. I've got 2 hours until World of Colour, so I don't want to do much, so I'm just going to chill, I think. Yeah, I'm not Disneyed out, I'm just tired because I actually slept a bit longer than I did last night than I had the other night. So I actually got 6 hours last night as opposed to 2, 3 or 4. Yeah, time difference is a bugger. I was going to say something else, but I'm not. So, yeah. I met Pluto before I left Disneyland, because of course, you know, now I'm in California Adventure again. Pluto's nice. A nice American man took my photo back, and it was great. Yeah, I was jumping up and down. I think there's a picture of Pluto jumping up and down with me because I was so excited. He saw my first timer badge. I haven't got anything else to say. Look at skyscraper over there. I could do a single rider for that if I wanted to move, which I don't. I am determined I'm going to stay up till midnight in Disneyland Park. I'm going to ride Splash Mountain over and over. I've decided I'm definitely doing that. Oh, there's a band over there. Little digital camera, so I may not have enough time footage for tomorrow and Sunday on this, but I have got my big bridge camera, which I haven't used on my memory card. I thought I'd take 100 shots on that, and I'd maybe take 100, maybe less than that. So I might use that for some video as well when I run out of room on this. I need to check my memory card for the World of Colour show. So I think that's about half an hour, so I'm going to change my big memory card because it's only a 4 gigabyte one. Yeah. places except for Pocahontas, and Pocahontas is never in Disneyland California because she's too busy having too much fun at Animal Kingdom in Epcot, Walt Disney World, which is a real shame, but that's quite an achievement really, meeting all the Disney princesses bar Poca. So that's pretty cool. I was going to my Goofy Sky School, I was going to take you on it with me, but apparently they're not doing a single rider tonight. So I'm going to take another trip under the sea. I'm just going to ask these people where the blue area might be for modern colour. They might have a better idea. Fast pass not too far from here, so I shall utilize it.